the judge, Genesis 18, verses 20 to 25, and the Lord said, because the cry of Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very grievous, I will go down and see whether they have done altogether according to the cry of it, which is come unto me. And if not, I will know. And the men turned their faces, that is the two angels, turned their faces from thence or from there and went towards Sodom. But Abraham stood yet before the Lord. And Abraham drew near and said, wilt thou also destroy the righteous with the wicked? Peradventure, perhaps there be 50 righteous within the city. Wilt thou also destroy and not spare the place for the 50 righteous that are therein? Let be far from thee to do after this manner, to slay the righteous with the wicked, and that the righteous should be as the wicked. Let be far from thee. Shall not the judge of all the earth do right? And he will do right. He will always do right. You know, there's only one just God. There's only one just judge, and that is God. You see, we think of the judges of this world, and they make mistakes. And some of them are corrupt. And they will receive bribes and let someone off. And people get away, literally, with murder these days in the courts of men. But you see, there is a judgment coming. When those who are not saved, not born again into God's family through faith in Jesus Christ, when they will stand before the judge, and that judge is the Lord Jesus Christ, and it will be absolute, righteous and just judgment. There will be no bribes there. We cannot get away with anything. That's what I'm trying to say. 1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse 10, the first part. The adversaries of the Lord shall be broken to pieces. Out of heaven shall he thunder upon them. The Lord shall judge the ends of the earth. The Psalm 50 verse 6, and the heavens shall declare his righteousness, for God is judge himself, Selah. Psalm 96 verse 10, say among the heathen that the Lord reigneth. The Lord also shall be established, that it shall not be moved. He shall judge the people righteously. Romans 2:16, in the day when God shall judge the secrets of men by Jesus Christ, according to my gospel. So here we have it. The judge will be the Lord Jesus Christ. The one who can be your Savior today. Because of our sin, we need a Savior. We need salvation from those sins. And because we are going down away from God, further and further away from God, and going down to the place called hell. But God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. If you come this afternoon and acknowledge that you're a sinner, change your mind, agree with God that you are a sinner, it's called repentance in the Word of God. If you come in that manner, humble yourself before God and realize and acknowledge that you are a sinner before Him. Not only that, but then you must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. You can have forgiveness for your sin this afternoon if you will do that. Because the Lord Jesus Christ has suffered on account of your sin and mine. He himself has no sin. He's the only perfect man that walked the face of the earth, that is Jesus Christ. John, chapter 5, verse 22, for the Father judgeth no man, but hath committed all judgment unto the Son. Acts 17:31, because he hath appointed a day, that is, God has appointed a day, in the which he will judge the world in righteousness by that man whom he hath ordained, whereof he hath given assurance unto all men, in that he hath raised him from the dead. And that is the guarantee that there is a judgment day coming. The Lord Jesus Christ died on account of our sin. Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried and he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. He desires that you and I might have our sins forgiven. And it's only through faith in him that that can come about. We cannot work our way to heaven. We cannot pay our way to heaven even by paying money. There is only one way, and that is through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ. By faith. It's through the grace of God and our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ that our sins will be forgiven. Hebrews 9 verses 27 and 28, and as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this the judgment, so Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. You know, the Christians are waiting for the time when the Lord Jesus Christ will come down into the air and take his people to be forever with himself in heaven. I wonder, are you headed for heaven? This afternoon, as you hear this message, are you right with God? Have your sins been forgiven? This is the most important thing in your whole life's history down here on earth, that you get right with God. Because you and I, in our unsaved state, in our unforgiven state, are not right with God. We need forgiveness for our sins. That's why we read in the Word of God that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hebrews 9 verses 27 and 28. I'll just repeat that, I've already quoted it, but as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this the judgment, so Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. You see, if we just died and it was a finish, I wouldn't be here. I would be just wasting my time. But I know I'm not wasting my time. Because after death there is judgment because of our sin. Because of our sinfulness before the Lord. We need to understand that we're guilty, hell-deserving sinners. And yet God will have all men to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth, which is only found in the Lord Jesus Christ. Revelation 20 verses 10 to 15, and the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. And I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away. And there was found no place for them. You see, there's no place to hide. Nowhere to run. Nowhere to hide from this one who sits on this throne. The Lord Jesus Christ will be the judge. But you see, we can be your Savior this afternoon. That's why I'm here. God wants you to have an opportunity to come to know him. To come to have your sins forgiven through faith in his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And so there's found no places, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, and I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the Book of Life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books, according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them. And they were judged every man according to their works. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Lake of fire and brimstone. That is sulfur. It's a terrible place. God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. I wonder, who among us shall dwell with the everlasting burnings? That fire will never be put out. It's impossible. But there's no need to be there. There's no need to go there. The Lord Jesus Christ has died on account of your sins and mine. And if you believe on him, if you will receive him, if you will come in repentance, acknowledge you as a sinner, and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible promises and thou shalt be saved.